Hello, welcome back to my channel. My name is Brittany. I don't know if you guys heard or not, but I have a new favorite book of all time, and we're here to talk about that book today. Obviously, by the title of this video, you know that that is The Starless Sea by Erin Morgenstern, and I'm not here to try to convince you to read it because I think that this book is for a very select few people who have a very specific, particular taste in books and reading and writing style. And if it's not for you, then you're gonna hate reading it. So I definitely am not trying to convince anyone to pick it up. I'm just here to list some reasons why I love this book and so that you get a little idea of what this book is like to see if maybe it's the book for you, because I know so many of you guys are on the fence about this book. And so there's been so many polarizing opinions. A lot of people don't know if they should pick this book up or not. So I'm just here to list some qualities about the book that I really enjoyed, let you know what it's about, and read some quotes from it so you can get a little bit of an idea of the writing style. Now, a quote that I love when researching for this video is from Erin Morgenstern herself, and it's within the book, and that says, "Books are always better when read rather than explained." That couldn't be more true, especially for this book, because there's a magical quality about it that cannot be described. Another quote from the book that describes this book perfectly says, "It is a sanctuary for storytellers and story keepers and story lovers. They eat and sleep and dream, surrounded by chronicles and histories and myths." If you don't know anything about what this book is about, we're following our main character, Zachary, who realizes early on in the book that he missed this chance to open a door. He finds that out because one day in the library, he checks out this book that's basically unregistered. And as he reads it, he discovers that this book has part of his past in it. And it's actually events that have taken place in his life, which he finds very interesting, but the rest of the book doesn't follow his life. So he really makes it his mission to find out whose book this is, where it came from, why part of his life is in it, and everything involving it. That's not actually where the book starts, because woven throughout this book, there are many other short stories, and it starts with one of those short stories. So a couple things about the style of this book. It's a very grim book. It's definitely not a bright and happy and joyous, like whimsical, happy, magical book. It's very grim and dark and mysterious with outlandish settings and seas of honey and things that are not logical, things that are very mysterious, but at the same time, almost a little bit disturbing or scary at times. The setting is so vivid and well described in this book that you can pretty much always sense everything that's going around you, whether that's sight or smell or a taste or a feeling. Everything is described in detail to perfection, to where you really feel like you're in this world. Two of the quotes that stood out the most to me while reading this book, I will read for you. The first one says, "For a while I was looking for a person, but I didn't find them. And after that, I was looking for myself. Now that I've found me, I'm back to exploring, which is what I was doing in the first place before I was doing anything else. And I think I was supposed to be exploring all along." And that just speaks to my heart on another level. It's just absolutely beautiful. And another one, sort of in the same vein, says, "A girl lost in the woods is a different sort of creature than a girl who walks purposefully through the trees, even though she does not know her way. The girl in the woods is not lost. She is exploring." I think that for me, it's really helpful if you can get a taste for the writing style to decide if it's something that you want to pick up, because as I said, this is for a very specific group of people. Only that group of people is going to enjoy this. And before I get into that list, this book means so much to me that if you guys watch my vlog, you'll have seen that I plan on getting a tattoo for this book. Even if you guys haven't read this, you probably have heard about The Sword, the Key, and the Bee. And I already have a dagger on my arm, so that kind of goes perfectly with it. I'm planning on getting a tattoo of a bee, not just like a tiny little insect looking bee. So the first reason that you may like this book is if you're a book lover and you love books about books. This whole entire book is about other books. As I said, there's other stories in it. We're in libraries, beneath the ground. Everything is revolving around these really important books, this book that he has that's unregistered within the library, and this sort of secret society that protects books. Everything in this story is revolving around books, but done in a fantastic way, where it's not cheesy whatsoever, because there's so many books about books that I actually despise. And I'm going to read a couple quotes for each of the reasons I list that just sort of tie in what I'm saying so that you can see a little bit about the book itself. Far beneath the surface of the earth, hidden from the sun and the moon, upon the shores of the starless sea, there is a labyrinth collection of tunnels and rooms filled with stories. Stories written in books and sealed in jars and painted on walls. Odes inscribed onto skin and pressed into rose petals. Tales laid in tiles upon the floors. Bits of plot worn away by passing feet. Legends carved in crystal and hung from chandeliers. Stories cataloged and cared for and revered. Old stories preserved while new stories spring up around them. Strange, isn't it? To love a book when the words on the pages become so precious that they feel like part of your own history because they are. It's nice to finally have someone read stories I know so intimately. So I think that these just really describe the atmosphere of the book so well, how it's sort of whimsical and nonsensical in the way that it's written and metaphorical, but also it really speaks directly to the people who find books as a means of escape from this world, and they find their happiness within books. And the second reason sort of ties right into that, so I'm not going to talk about it too much, but that's if you love short stories or stories within other stories. This book involves multiple short stories set within this, and they're sort of spaced out sporadically. There's not a ton of logic to them. You don't really get a ton of real great explanations for them. I mean, you do a little bit, but I know that some people dislike books within a book, so I just wanted to put out there that there are definitely multiple stories within this. Personally, for me, that was one of my favorite things about it. Sometimes I enjoyed the short stories even more than the main overarching story. So I found them so enjoyable. That's just gonna be very hit or miss depending on the reader. A quote from the book says, "But that is the nature of a story. Not all stories speak to all listeners, but all listeners can find a story that does somewhere, sometime in one form or another." And that pretty much just wraps it up, because this book is only gonna speak to some of us. The next reason that you may or may not like this book is if you enjoy portal fantasies, then you should at least have a better chance of enjoying this book, because there's definitely like a doorway that takes you to another place, and these are sort of magical doors and keys and things like that. A quote from the book says, "These doors will sing silent siren songs for those who seek what lies behind them, for those who feel homesick for a place they've never been to, those who seek even if they do not know what or where it is that they are seeking. Those who seek will find. Their doors have been waiting for them." If you are a fan of like Wayward Children or Narnia or just any type of portal fantasy where you can escape into another world, I think that you will enjoy this book, because it definitely involves a portal to another world. Tying right into that, this book is for those who feel lost in this world and at home while reading a book, at home lost in a fantasy book, at home in another world. Those of us still waiting on our Hogwarts letters, and those of us who never feel quite right in this world, but imagine that they would feel right at home in another world. If you can relate to that at all, I think that this is the book for you. And I have quite a few quotes to read for this one, so feel free to skip ahead if you want. But I sort of want to make this video for myself so that I can look back on some of my favorite quotes from this book. These are not spoilers whatsoever. It's just some of the most beautiful quotes from this that I feel like you can really get a taste from the book to see if you enjoy it or not. So the first one says, "He tells her about moving from place to place to place and never feeling like he ever belonged in any of them. How wherever he was, he would almost always rather be someplace else, preferably somewhere fictional. He tells her how he worries that none of it means anything. I have literally always been the kid who believes in fairy tales, but I didn't know what to do because I wasn't a kid. I was a 20-something in a cocktail bar who never feels old enough to drink. So I said, I don't know." So for those of us who believe in magic, this book is for you. This quote is from Zachary, and it just says how when he felt himself falling, he would go and find a new book and fall into it instead and be someone somewhere else for a while. And that's exactly what this book does. It transports you to another place in time where you forget you even live in the real world. You forget and you zone out everything else that's going on around you because you are so sucked into this world and this reality of this book that everything else sort of fades away and it doesn't matter for a while you're open in the pages of this book. nothing else is relevant. And that is a powerful book, in my opinion, if it can make you forget about everything. Another quote says, "I think people come here for the same reason we came here," Dorian says, "in search of something, even if we didn't know what it was, something more, something to wonder at, someplace to belong. We're here to wander through other people's stories, searching for our own." So if you're the type of reader who thrives on connecting the story in a book with your own life and searching for your own story within the story that another author has written, I think this book's for you. Now, another thing to know about this book, the next reason, is that if you are a reader who loves whimsical magic that's never really clearly explained, then you might enjoy this book. You will not get clear answers for everything you have questions about. And as a reader, I'm somebody who loves that. I love open endings. I'm not saying this has an open ending or doesn't. I'm not gonna spoil anything, but I personally love things that are very soft and flowing in magic, to where there's no hard yes or no or direct answers, and things just kind of are, and you have to just read it and believe it. You absolutely have to do that, because if you're looking at this from a logical perspective, or you want like a hard magic system or defined things you can and can't do, this is absolutely not the book for you. If you want explanations and answers, this is not the book for you. If you want to just read something and be told something and believe it and believe in it with this childlike faith that the storyteller is going to handle you with care, then this is the book for you. One of my favorite quotes that kind of coincides with this is, "What is this?" he asks, meaning all of it, everything, and trusting she will understand. "I will never have a satisfying answer to that question, Ezra," she says, and the smile that accompanies the sentiment is a sad one. This is the rabbit hole. Do you want to know the secret to surviving once you've gone down the rabbit hole? Zachary nods and Mirabelle leads forward. Her eyes are ringed with gold. "Be a rabbit," she whispers. Another quote says, "How are you feeling?" Zachary asks. "Like I'm losing my mind, but in a slow, achingly beautiful sort of way." And you will sort of feel like that when you're reading this book. Like you're losing your mind because you're trying so desperately to figure out how everything ties together and you just really don't know where it's going. So if you like being lost in a book and confused and trying to figure out what's happening, but being okay without ever really knowing, this book is for you. I think most people know that this book has a very purple prose, very metaphorical writing style. It's very over the top, and some say totally unnecessary, or I have heard so many people say, not just one or two, I've heard so many people say this book is weird just for the sake of being weird. Even so, if that's the case, like, I love it. Give me more. I like things that are weird for being weird. It's different. It's new. It is engaging and interesting, and we need more weird. So if you like purple prose, metaphorical writing, very, very metaphorical writing, this book is for you. If not, probably don't pick it up. I don't think you'll enjoy it at all. One of my favorite quotes that describes this perfectly, I think this is a great taste test, where if you like this quote, then you'll like the book. If this is very illogical to you and annoying, don't pick this book up. Sorry, it's so poetry today. The weather. It's like a poem where each word is more than one thing at once and everything's a metaphor, the meaning condensed into rhythm and sound and the spaces between sentences. It's all intense and sharp, like the cold in the wind. And the other person says, "You could just say it's cold out." And she says, "I could." And if you want something direct and to the point, don't read this book. But if you want something that says things in a nonsensical way to get from A to B, this is for you. Now, the last thing that I wanted to say that might help you decide if you want to pick this book up is that if you like stories that are not all happy and full of sunshine and rainbows and unicorns, if you like things that tackle depression or more heavy topics and tackling the meaning of what it means to be alive and happy, then you'll really enjoy this, because this is much more of like a melancholy, gloomy feeling. It's definitely not a happy, cheerful book by any means. And that's why it appeals to me so much, because I think that it deals with the issue of depression and being unhappy in the world that you live in. And one quote from the book says, "Important things hurt sometimes." Dorian smiles at the statement, despite the truth of it or because of it. Another quote says, "But I also think most of us are two steps away from jumping off something most of the time, and you never know if the next day is going to push you in one direction or another. There is no fixing. There is only moving forward in the brokenness." And the last quote I want to read that sort of gives you a feeling of what this book is like says, "A book is an interpretation," she says. "You want a place to be like it was in the book, but it's not a place in a book. It's just words. The place in your imagination is where you want to go. And that place is imaginary. This is real. She places her hand on the wall in front of them. The stone is cracked near her fingers, a fissure running down the side and disappearing into a column. You could write endless pages, but the words will never be the place. Besides, that's what it was, not what it is. So it's sort of a book dealing with your expectations of what you want and what you imagine and what your creativity in your head is capable of. And then sometimes we face these harsh realities in life that things aren't what you expect them to be. And that's just life. And you have to deal with it. And how are you going to deal with it when you come to that stage where you figure these things out for yourself? So I think that these dark, heavy topics are discussed in an absolutely beautiful way. Like I said, this book overall to me is just jaw-droppingly beautiful, stunning, whimsical. It makes you feel like every emotion under the sun. But the biggest thing for me was it just was able to transport me out of this world while reading it. And I don't get that feeling very often. It's very, very rare. I know there's a couple of you out there that agree with me and will think that this book is everything to you. I think the majority of you will be like, I'm staying far, far away from that book because it sounds like everything I despise. I have heard from a ton of people too that they hate and love this book at the same time because you can't deny how beautifully written and well written this book is. That's just undeniable and objectively true. Whether your heart and mind connect to it and your soul connects to it on a different level, I think that just depends on where you are at in life and what your tastes are. So I hope that you were able to take something away from this video, even if it was just a bunch of pretty quotes from the book, or maybe now you know you never want to pick this book up and you don't have to wonder if it's for you anymore. But I just wanted to share some of my favorite things about my new favorite book, since you all know how excited I am to have found a new favorite book. Let me know if you guys like these style videos where it's not so like dry and cut of a review, more of an abstract opinion based discussion of the book, reasons you may like it, because I find as a reader that's sort of helpful if you list some things of why you may or may not like the book. I think that's more helpful. So let me know what you guys think in the comments below. Let me know if you've read this book, whether you've loved or hated it, and let me know if you have changed your mind, whether you're gonna pick it up or not pick it up based on this video. I would love to hear from you guys, but thank you guys for watching and I will see you next time.